Welcome to Knitspired. This is episode 16, and I am Kamiko. This is a knitting yarn type podcast. And today is Monday, February 26, 2018. It's been quite a while since I recorded. Again, I feel like I say that every episode. It's so hard to start an episode. I have had to stop my camera and record numerous times. I would never be able to do a live video. It's just so hard. Yeah, it's hard. if you podcast, you know. Sometimes I wish I had someone to podcast with. My cat's in here. Maybe he'll join me. I am an American knitter living in Ontario, Canada. And yeah, I'm trying a little bit of a different setup today. I'm in my office that I'm normally in, but I'm using my iPad to record. I haven't used that before. I usually use just a little point-and-shoot Samsung digital camera. So I wanted to try the iPad and see how that goes. Yeah, you'll have to let me know. I don't know what the audio's like. Hopefully the lighting is okay. I did decide to record during the day today. Normally I do it when nobody's around or when the baby's sleeping. My husband's out or down in his office or something, but I wanted to get good lighting today, and I think I'm looking in the right spot, so I'm sorry if my eyes like are darting back and forth because I'm looking at the time and I'm looking at the camera, so I'm sorry. But anyway, all that, welcome to the podcast. Welcome to all returning viewers and to the new viewers. Thank you so much for joining me today, and to all of you, thank you so much for taking some time out and listening to me talk. I can't believe it. like I said, it's been a while. Did I say that? I did say it before, but if I didn't say it, it's been a while. And I was just thinking about how much I miss podcasting, and it is so much fun to do it. And once I get back into it and then I get a little bit more comfortable with the camera and stuff, it's a little bit easier. But yeah, here I am. And I do have notes, so if I am looking down, it's just I needed to keep track of some stuff just so that I knew, so I didn't forget anything. And I have a whole pile of stuff here. It's a mess. I'll get into that later, but the rest of the mess. But yeah, you should see this pile of mess I have right here. But it's creations that I'm going to share with you. So it's really nice out today. It's very sunny and bright, and that's super exciting. And I think it's, I didn't go outside yet, but I think my phone said it's 4 degrees Celsius, so that's better than minus 22, which it was back when I was podcasting last time. Yeah, so it's getting a little bit warmer out. I don't think it got this warm this early on, because we're still in February, and maybe it's just a teaser and it's going to get cold again, but March is just around the corner, like this week, so that's exciting. I have a lot of something very exciting happening in my life that I will share at the end if you are interested. Nothing crazy, but it's exciting. And I guess I'm just going to get into showing you my finished objects. First of all, I have a couple of silly ones because I was feeling creative and my daughter wanted something, so I made her, it's just a crocheted little hat, and it's kind of goofy, and I'm not crazy about it, but she likes it. It is a unicorn hat. It's a mess now because she's just been wearing it and stuff, but here, I don't even know where the ears are. Here we go. It's just a little crocheted unicorn. She is obsessed with My Little Pony, so I was like, oh, she would love to have be a little unicorn pony. So I made this for her, and I actually made it for her and gave it to her the day we registered her for kindergarten, so she wore it into the school, and she was shy and being silly, and the principal was like, oh, are you a little unicorn? And she thought that was cool. It kind of was a little icebreaker for her, but there's that. And then the very next day, because a unicorn wasn't enough, and she's also obsessed with Elsa and Anna from Frozen, I had to crochet her this Elsa braid hat, because who doesn't want an Elsa braid when they're almost 4 years old? So this, she has worn the crap out of it, if you can't tell. They're both made of acrylic yarn, just because it was easier and cheaper, and she has destroyed it. And it's pilly and dirty, but she loves it, and that's what counts. So those are my fun, silly little things. They took, like, seriously, I could watch one-hour episode on, like, Netflix of something, and finish it within that time. It's so easy, you know how quick crocheting is. So there's that. The other object, I forgot to bring it up here, but it is a, here, let me get the yarn. This is I was looking for a chunky yarn for something. I wanted a chunky cowl, and it's Scarfy, I think that's the name of it, by Lion Brand. And let me see if I have the tag in here, sorry, off camera. Yeah, it is in the charcoal / magenta colorway. And yeah, it's the Scarfy yarn. And I believe, yeah, it's 78% acrylic and 22% wool. So, you know, you can just go with that. But it's this color. It's got the charcoal and magenta. And the scarf, or I made a cowl out of it. Sorry, I hear noises. It's hard to talk when there's other people around. Anyway, it was a 2x2 rib cowl. And it came out awesome and chunky and really pretty, and it's exactly what I wanted, but there's a ton left over, so I started making some, like, just knitting up some quick ribbed fingerless knits. So there's that, and I have to dig some more. Sorry, off camera again. Let's see. So I don't know if you remember, I talked about, I was up in Thunder Bay, Ontario this summer visiting my brother-in-law and sister-in-law, and I brought my sister-in-law to a local yarn store. She does not knit, but she wants to, and she has in the past. So she actually picked out a couple of skeins of yarn, and this is the, I'm sorry, I don't have the tags in front of me, but I know this is Regia, and it's the yarn that it makes two pairs of socks in one ball, and they match exactly. And it's not the Arnie and Carlos. I don't think I saw that on it. It's the Perfect. But it didn't say Arnie and Carlos on it. Anyway, I just finished these last week, and she did try them on. Well, she tried one of them on, and it fit great. So they came out awesome. I love the way they came out. I think it looks amazing. A regular heel flap. They're a little messy because they've been folded up, and I just threw them on my sock blockers right now, but I can't wait to give the finished pair to her. So there's that. I'm really happy about those. It's not the first pair of socks I've made for somebody else. I don't make socks for other people just because I don't really understand, like, how to fit other people, because I know I make my socks to fit myself. So I don't know how that works. Sorry, there's going to be a lot of eye darting because I hear stuff happening. It's really hard to record with other people around because I know my husband's not standing at the door, and I told him I'm recording, so I put some music on so they can't hear me. It's really embarrassing. I'm like talking to myself. But he gets it. He likes all this stuff that I do because it makes me happy. Let's see, what else did I do? Those are the things that I finished, and I think that's all I finished. Works in progress. I still have my dad's sock head hat, and I haven't finished it, mostly because I'm doing it in magic loop and my needles aren't long enough. And I just got a revelation. I think these are 2.75, which is 2, size US size 2. I might have those on double pointed needles, and I should just finish it that way. But anyway, that's my dad's sock head hat, and it's made with Patton's Croix yarn. I got a bunch of them at a big tent sale this past, the end of the summer. So I really want to finish that so I can send it to him. It's going to be warm by the time he gets it. They live in Massachusetts, so it's still cold, but it'll get cold again. Anyway, I want to finish that. It's cute. Cute for my dad. So that is just sitting there on the needles. I think I've knit a couple of rows in the past month. I don't know. I don't know what to tell you. What else do I have? Okay. Once again, my speckle and pop. Sorry, I'm all over the place today, but that's okay. You don't care, do you? I'm very disorganized, as always. So, my speckle and pop Stephen West knit-along is officially not a knit-along anymore because it ended like 6 months ago. I am so close to being done. So close to being done. And I don't think I really got much more progress on it since the last time I showed you. And it's mid-row. The problem is not with the shawl. I was knitting and pulling along the yarn like you do. Like, not crazy. I'm not like crazy rough with it. Well, my needle fell out and it left about 1,000 stitches just laying out there in the nether. Just laying out there. Talk about a heart attack moment. Yeah. And I was like, oh no. And I was thinking they're interchangeables. And then I realized once I found everything and I got the stitches back on, because that was the most important thing, was to get my stitches not live anymore. Or not live, but like secured. I realized they're not interchangeable needles. They're fixed. And it was a good pair of needles. It was Knitter's Pride Nova Platina. I have the thing right here. And I bought them specifically for this knit-along. And I was like, well, if I got a nice, good pair of needles, then they're probably gonna stand by them. So I messaged a few knitting people and I got a few responses. And then I did message Knitter's Pride and they said, just go back to the store that you got them from. But I have yet to do that because the store is not close by. I have to go and I keep forgetting. So that means my speckle and pop is on hold. I was really hoping to finish it. And right now, as I'm looking at it, it's beautiful, but there's a glaring mistake that nobody else will notice. But I will. But it's okay. It still looks cool. Yeah. So there's the speckle and pop. You can see the big holes going on there. See how much I have left? Just not too bad. Not too much. But I was very sad about that. And plus, I love these needles. So, but they'll stand by. They stood by them already. They already sent me a message and said that you can just return them to the store. So I will do that. And what else do I have? I'm doing works in progress? Okay. So I'll go back to a couple of projects that I've been working on that I did show you before. And these are both done on, I believe, Patton's Croix. I'm sorry, I'm not looking at the camera much. No, they're not both Patton's Croix. These are the Wonderland Socks by Tabitha Gandy from the Hey Sister podcast. And they are to have an afterthought heel. Look, they don't have a heel yet, see? And I still haven't cut into them. I'm supposed to do that, and I'm really afraid. So I've just been postponing it, and So I still have those to work on, so they're technically still a work in progress. And then also the her sweater weather socks. So I got only to a certain point because I didn't know the exact measurement where I needed to start decreasing for the toe. And it's a big spaghetti mess, but that's the back of it up till, that's just the back to the heel. And then here is where I'm going to do the afterthought. And then that's the front of it. And I still only have one on the needles. I haven't started the second one yet, but this is a Patton's Croix yarn in rainbow, which is fun. So those are still works in progress that I showed you before. Another one is just these socks. Oh, this is kind of cool. Okay, so this yarn that I used for these socks is just a plain stockinette stitch sock. I found some yarn. It's sock yarn. And it's Red Heart. I just saw the tag too. It's Red Heart, Heart and Soul. I had never heard of it before. And I got two balls of it because they're 50 grams each. And when I saw it, I was like, ooh, that looks really cool. And it's 73% wool, 27% nylon. So it's that. And the colorway is jelly beans. And this is what it looks like. That is the ball of yarn. It's nice yarn to work with. It's actually kind of soft, softer than Patton's Croix. And it's kind of rainbowy too. But then when I knit it up, it didn't look like a like stripes rainbow. It's just like a variegated. So that's the first sock. And I really like them. The color is not showing up so true. Let's see. It looks way more muted in the camera. Maybe that way. It's funny, in the camera it looks really different. Like you can see these stripes, and to me, it doesn't look like that. Maybe from far away it does, I don't know. But anyway, they're really fun, happy socks. Here. This is what they look like, I guess, from the front. Anyway, yeah, that's another one that I'm doing. That's actually the first pair of socks that I cast on this year for myself. And I'm still working on it, and it's very different from last year because last year I was very prolific with socks, and I'm still knitting socks this year, obviously, but just not concentrating on them so much because I started my Comfort Fade Cardi, and I did enter in the Comfort Fade knit along and in the Wool and Vine or Yarngasm podcast Year of the Garment. Along? I don't even remember. I didn't do my homework. I don't know. Anyway, so for the Comfort Fade Cardi, I bought bear yarn, which I showed you in the last podcast, and I did dye it myself. So the first skein of yarn that I dyed, I think I only did one ball of it, and I don't know where it is right now, but you'll see when I show you the sweater. The second, it uses four colors. Sorry, off camera. It uses four colors, and I dyed them all, and it's a DK weight, which is weird because to me DK is so thick and it feels like worsted weight to me. Maybe it's just because I use sock yarn all the time. It just seems as thick as worsted weight. But this is the second color that I dyed, and it's like a gray with some peachy orange inside and then some cream still, like some of the bear wool still showing through. So that's the second color. Then the third color still has the gray and the orange, but then I added like a pink. There's some pops of like fuchsia somewhere in there, like a lighter fuchsia, I guess, like right in there and stuff. So that's kind of cool. And then the third color is even lighter, so it still has a little bit of the orange in it, a lot of the bare undyed plain color coming through, and then the pink still. So I thought that came out really cool. I was really happy with those. But the first color was a little, I like it a lot, but I didn't really know what I was doing for colors. So I didn't really think it all the way through. And now I'm like, oh, I don't know what to do about this. It does look cool because it does kind of fade, but this is the back of it. And on camera, it's not so bad. See how it's like really bright blues and orange right there? But like I have the gray going throughout the entire sweater. There's just a lot of gray right in here, but I don't know. What do you think? I think it looks kind of cool. I'm not gonna be afraid to wear it. It's my first time doing this. I'm pretty happy with it. So, okay, that's it from the front. And I did try it on and it looks tiny, but it fits me and I got gauge. Of course, I didn't do gauge swatch until I had already knit like about this much of it, like from the top down. So that's my gauge swatch. I don't do that stuff. I'm bad at that. But I'm already in the ribbing, actually, on the bottom of it. So I'm pretty happy with it. Maybe it's looking more muted on camera. I'm not sure if I should like over dye it, but I wouldn't really want to know what to do. I wouldn't really know what to do because I like these colors. So I don't know. And actually they're all not even really my colors. So sorry, I'm looking not at the camera, I'm looking in the screen. So sorry. But it does look kind of cool. what do you think? What would you do? I did consider ripping the whole thing out when I was still like here, but I was like, I'm not gonna do that. I'm just gonna let it be and we'll see. I could always add like, I could over dye it and add blue, some more blues down here, but then the whole fade thing is not happening. But anyway, I was pretty happy with the way my colors came out. It was a lesson. I definitely know for my next sweater, which I probably will dye yarn again, what I'm gonna do, but I'm not sure about the whole fade thing. I don't know how much I like that. It's cool, but I don't know if it's my thing. I don't know. So, I think that is it for Works in Progress, except, okay, so obviously I have a lot of sock yarn left over, and I did crochet some hexagons. I've shown you those in the past, but I'm not really into the Cozy Memories blanket. No offense to anybody. I think they're great. They look awesome. And I'm not into the Granny Stripe blanket, and I also think that's great, but they just don't really do anything for me for some reason. So I was looking through scrappy blankets, and then I saw like the whole temperature blanket craze happening at the beginning of the year. Also not my thing. I just kind of do my own thing. I don't know. I always have to find something different. So anyway, I was looking up scrappy blankets online, and I came across this really cool looking boho type blanket, and I think it was on Anthropologie, and I was like, oh, that's really cool. So I took my bag of scrap yarns, and I did finish like with all the leftover sock yarn that I had. I finished up my hexagons that I've been crocheting, and I do have a pile, which I don't have right now. I have a pile like that big of crocheted hexagons, which will make a blanket about, let's be honest, like that big. You know how that goes. But no, I will definitely use them. They're cool. But I started taking the, I'm looking at it right now, sorry. All my scrap sock yarn, doubling it up so it's marled. And I started making this blanket, which is going to take like 10 years. Probably not, but 10 years. And I made sure that I wasn't mid-row. I finished this last row right before the before I started recording. And so this is what I have so far. There's, let's see, almost 6 inches, which isn't bad. I started this the very beginning of the year, like probably not January 1st, but close. And I just dropped about 20 stitches. And if you just heard that sound, that squeaky sound, that's my cat. He is, he's not even one yet. He's, let's see, we're in February. He's 10 months old and he's huge. Huge. And he's the awesomest cat ever. He's huge. He's a boy. He's just big. And he stuffs himself in this basket in my office here. I'm going to try to show it to you. His name is Henry. Look at it. It's a little basket. It's a basket of Henry, and he squishes himself up in there. Isn't that the cutest thing ever? He weighs like 25 pounds. That was him snoring. That big sound you heard a minute ago. Anyway, he looks very indifferent now. He's not too happy about that. He's the best cat ever. I don't think I'll ever get another female cat because he is the awesomest cat. He's like a puppy. He goes into my daughter's room every morning and she tortures him. She doesn't hurt him, but she tortures him. And she'll hold him close, like squished up. And he just sits there. I'll be watching in the monitor and he just sits there. He's like, he waits at her door for her to let him in. Anyway, he's the best cat. He's a pain in the butt, but he did learn the rules about the yarn, so that's good. Anyway, back to my blanket, now that I've picked up my stitches. This is it, and something about, I'm hoping that I feel like the colors are brighter, and maybe it'll come through when the video is actually, they're not as muted as it looks in the picture. So look at all my fringe. If it was a garment, I could enter it in the Mean Girls podcast fringe along, February fringe along, knit along, but it's not a garment. It's a blanket. So I started out being all fancy with it. I'm gonna get closer. See, it's ribbed. And then I realized that takes up not even an inch. Look at that. It's like, yeah, not even an inch. So I did like a, let's see, a knit one, purl one. I think I did, yeah, garter stitch for four rows. I did four rows of stockinette. I was doing a four row thing. Four rows of garter again, four rows of seed stitch. And then I was like, I did some yarn overs and then I started doing it. Like I really liked just the plain stockinette stitch down here. So from here on, sorry. From here on, I'm doing stockinette stitch. So it's purl in the back, sorry. Purl in the back and stockinette in the front. Anyway, so it's all squished up on my needles. My needles are too short and it's curling because there's a lot of stockinette in it. That is that. It's, I believe it's 400 stitches and it ends up being with them together, maybe like a DK weight. So not really sure how wide it's gonna be. Don't lose stitches. And that's the end. It's a mess right now. But so it's 6 inches. I have no idea how wide. I could do some math. I don't know how wide it's gonna be with 400 stitches across, but right now it's all squished up on that. I'm assuming it'll be like a, just like a throw lap size blanket. I love it. I think it's gonna look really, really cool. So that is using up, it is really eating up my sock yarn stash, which is exciting. It's a little scary to use it up, but it's like, well, that's what I wanted to do. I wanted to use up my yarn. Now, I think that is it for, sorry. Oh, one second. I'm gonna go off camera again because I need to look for something. Okay, here we go. So, one last thing, sorry about that. one last thing is I showed you these before, my Firmament socks. They were being test knit by some lovely ladies, including Rebecca from the Mean Girls podcast. And she had so many lovely things to say about it on her last podcast. I think it was their last one. And thank you so much for that. They're so, so sweet. Like they always mention me in their podcast, and I swear that got me more viewers. And thank you so much, Stephanie and Rebecca. You guys are awesome. I love you guys too. Anyway, these are my socks, and Rebecca test knit them for me. And they are now for sale. So they are up on Ravelry, in my Ravelry store. And I forgot to mention all the ways you can find me, but it's all below. Ravelry and Instagram, but that's all below. I'll show you, I'll tell you at the end too, or maybe at the beginning, I don't know. Yeah, I got some really good comments on them from the test knitters, which was really nice because I have never done this before. But that was so exciting and very difficult for me to publish them, not because it was hard to do, but because I was very apprehensive and I don't have a lot of confidence when it comes to that kind of stuff and putting myself out there. So it was kind of like a lesson in like, yeah, you can do this. So that gave me enough confidence to start writing more patterns, which is what I've been wanting to do anyway. So I do my next pair of socks that I knit is gonna be my own pattern. So it's something I've had in my head for a while and I will be starting on that soon and hopefully get it published soon. Cause I think it would be really cool to do like a collection of sock patterns. To me, I think that's fun. Yeah, it was really fun. And I have a local knitting group that I go to, and the girl that is the founder of it, she, last time we met up, she was like, hey, Kamiko, congratulations. And people, like, they just like stared over at me and I was like, oh, thank you so much. And then people are looking at it and stuff. They thought that was kind of neat because that's exciting. Which reminds me, I knit a hat that I'm actually gonna write up. It's a free pattern and I didn't bring it in here, and it's really cute. It's just super simple, like horizontal ribbing kind of, so like stockinette stitch and garter stitch, and I just wrote up a pattern really quick. I'm just gonna offer it for free because it is easy, I guess. What I did want to show. Wow, I am so. So yeah, my socks are published. Those socks are published, and I'm working on a new pair pretty soon. What I did want to show is something that I knit a long time ago. I've never shared this. I have a lot of stuff I knit a long time ago. So as you know, if you've watched me, I used to live in the States up until a few years ago, and I've been knitting forever. Not forever, but for a very long time. And one summer, I think like six summers ago, my parents rent a cottage in Narragansett, Rhode Island, and I went there with them. I visited for a couple days, and there's a store out there called The Mermaid's Pearl. I follow them on Instagram, and at that point, I was single and working a lot, but not making a lot of money, and so I didn't really have a lot to spend on yarn, but I loved to knit, obviously. So when I knit, I always bought like cheaper, less expensive yarns from Michaels, which was great. And I knit lots of stuff with that. Well, when you go on vacation, you know you're going on vacation, you kind of like put some money away, kind of. So I did. I purchased a book, which I don't have anymore because moving from the US to Canada, I had to get rid of a lot of stuff. And so I had some cool knitting books, basically cool knitting books, and they were a lot of garment. There were a lot of garment patterns in the books, and I don't remember the name of this book, and I really do wish I had brought these books with me because they were. I don't have any pattern books now, any knitting books, because you can get everything online and it's easier and there's less stuff, which is good, but it's kind of nice to have a book there. Anyway, I had picked out a pattern for a cardigan that I wanted to make when I was visiting my parents in Narragansett for vacation for that summer, and picked out the pattern, and I wasn't also really knowledgeable about yarn weights and different fibers and gauge and all that kind of stuff. I was basically in like hat land, fingerless mitt land, and like little accessories, and that's what I did. I knit, mostly it was knitting for therapeutic reasons. It just made me feel better. I didn't even care. It was more about the process, not the product at that point. Now it's about both. The process right now is very calming to me, and the products are fun. I have a million socks now. I have stuff I've made that I can wear. It's fun. But I didn't do that before. It was just process. And, but this time I was like, all right, I'm going to make this sweater. So my mom kind of helped me. We went to the local yarn store, the Mermaid's Pearl, and picked out some yarn. And I knew I was going to spend quite a bit of money. I wish I knew what yarn it was. I purchased the yarn there. My mom actually ended up purchasing half of it for me because she knew I was kind of in not exactly overflowing with a bank account. Anyway, I don't know the name of the pattern. I don't know the name of the yarn, but I made this sweater, and it's 6 years ago, I think. Still not completely woven in. That might be a pull. Yep, I believe that is a pull. That's pulled. Not cool. But anyway, a friend of mine seamed it up and sewed the sides together because she was like, you're never going to finish this. So she did that, which is cool. It is not finished. I've never worn it. I've tried it on, but I've never worn it. It is more fitted at the top, and then it flares out at the bottom like that. And same with the arms. The arms are more fitted at the top, and then they flare out at the bottom. And it's kind of showing up. It's like a coppery color. It is so squishy. You can see that it's got a little bit of a halo. I have no idea. I wish I knew what yarn it was, but it's, I don't even know what fiber it is. I have no idea. I knit all of this. I didn't put all of it together, but I knit it. Like my friend did this. She did the seaming for me, most of the seaming. I have no idea what size needles I used. I don't even know what the, I don't know. I know nothing about it. It's not my style. But this yarn is amazing. It is rough, but not rough. It's soft enough to wear close to your skin as a sweater. And I've been thinking, I wanted to show it, like one of my first higher quality garments, except that awesome pole right there, which can obviously be fixed. I wanted to show it to you, to show you what I've, just what I did. But I'm thinking I might want to take it apart and make something with it that I can actually use, because I am knitting garments this year. So let me know what you think about it. There are mistakes, but for somebody who wasn't like that schooled in certain things about knitting, I did pretty good. It's kind of cool because like up to this point, so from here it's a garter for a couple of rows, and then it's a 2x2 rib down to here, and then after that it's like a broken rib, is it? Oh, it's knit on one side and a rib on the other side, so it gives you like a garter stitch rib, I guess that's what it's called. See what I mean? So underneath it's not, it's knit. Whereas this is the inside of it. That's ribbed and this is knit. You know what I mean? Anyway, it is nice, but it's not my style. It's not finished. I don't even have any more the yarn anymore, if there was leftover. I think there was. But it's really special to me because it was like, it was expensive to make. And my mom helped me out buying the yarn. And I had actually left it in the States, and she sent it to me once. And I didn't expect that because it was just like one of those things that there were other more important things that I needed to bring over. If you know my life, that might sound weird. But anyway, I think I might take it apart. What do you think? And then make something really nice out of it, because it's awesome yarn. I don't want to just, that's the thing. I don't want to just like fold it up and put it away or hang it in the closet, because I could use it. You know, it's heavy, it's warm, it's beautiful, it's a nice color, all that stuff. So let me know what you think about that. That was a lot of rambling for nothing. I did think this was kind of cool. I was going through some stuff in my office and I came across some Chiagus I had never opened. So I have another pair of 40 inch circulars. They're US 2.5 3mm, and that's what I knit my socks on. So I found those. I forgot that I had gotten three pairs for some reason. I ordered them on Amazon, and yeah, I just came across them the other day because I was pretty sure that I had three pairs, but I've only been using two, and I'm like, where is that third pair? I found it. And speaking of needles that I've found, I was going through some needles the other day and I forgot I use bamboo needles a lot. And that's how rough I am on my needles. They, not only do they bend, like they're, my bamboo needles are bent a little, even some of my metal needles are. That one broke, and I think, I don't know why I kept it, but yeah, it broke. That's pretty awesome. I'm rough on my needles, but bamboo needles, and these are US size ones, so they're really tiny, like little toothpicky things. But I think I was using them because, let's see, oh, on my socks that I'm working on right now, I think I might have showed these last time. I got the Chiagu 9-inch needles, and my thoughts on the 9-inch needles, I always want to say 9-inch nails, my 9-inch circulars, is they're great. That's a great idea, but I love them and I hate them. And then every time I think I hate them and I'll never use them again, I love them again, because they can be really fast and it can, I don't know, it is fun to use them, and you don't have to like pull the magic loop through, which is my preferred method. And I'm not a big fan of DPNs, although I've been thinking about getting some carbons because I heard they're great for DPNs for socks. But as far as sock knitting goes, I think I prefer magic loop. And I do like these 9-inch needles, but when I knit on them, right here hurts a little bit, and I never have like hurt, my wrists and hands never hurt when I knit, so I don't want that to be, I don't want that to be something that is happening where my wrists and my hands are hurting when I'm knitting. I'm like, I can't knit anymore because that would suck. So I don't know. I will keep them, I think. Oh, and another thing about the 9-inch needles is that when you're, is that what it's called? Yeah, 9-inch needles, 9-inch circulars, is that when you are, I do the heel flap, you have to split, to do the heel, you have to use like a straight needle, not a straight needle, but a DPN to do that, which you don't have to do with Magic Loop, you just use the same needle the whole time, so you have to have another needle around when you're doing, when you're using the 9-inch circulars. So those are my thoughts on it. I probably won't use these again, but then again, I probably will, because you know me. So those are my thoughts on my 9-inch circulars, if you were wondering. So everybody says you either love them or you hate them. Of course, I don't love them or hate them. I'm in the middle. And yeah. So yeah, you know, yesterday I knit from, you like my little, I stay true. This is, I always use a bread tag to tie up the yarn so it's not flopping around everywhere. Anyway, yesterday I knit like the, like three rows of the ribbing on the cuff and all of that. And then what I was just knitting right now, I, was what I did today. I knit all of that yesterday. And these are size ones, I believe. What does it say? It doesn't. These are 2.25? Yes, size ones. US size ones. So they're little. They're smaller than I normally knit on. I have to do a 64 cast on for size ones. I could probably go up like to 72, but I have very skinny ankles and skinny feet, so it works for me. If it was for anybody else, I'd probably go up a little bit because they're pretty skinny, but they stretch, you know. Anyway, I feel like I've gone off on a rant. So that is it as far as my knitting and yarn stuff, and it looks like I am at 42 minutes. Normally I can't tell because I use a different camera and it doesn't have the counter on it. And is it still recording? Yes, it is. Yay. That's good. So I talked about, I have some exciting stuff going on. We're moving. Yeah. So we live in a townhouse. I've told you before, we've lived here for a year, a little over, like a year and 3 months. And it's a cool townhouse. It's really big. Bonus, when we got it, we didn't expect to have a basement or a garage or a third bedroom. We came from a two-bedroom apartment, like on the seventh floor. So this was like great. So we got a finished basement, which is my husband's office. We got a garage, which is his gym because he works out, and it also stores our supplies for his cleaning business. And then I got a third bedroom. We got a third bedroom, and I use it for my office, which is where I am right now. And we have a huge master bedroom. We have two bathrooms. We didn't expect any of that. So it was affordable-ish. Rent is very expensive here. And it worked. It worked for us. But once you move into a place and there are things wrong with it, you know, that kind of stinks. And of course there are things wrong with it, but that's not a big deal. It's more of the fact that the landlord doesn't want to fix things. He wants a, like, so for instance, this is just one of the things. When it was really cold out in the beginning of January, our pipes froze in our kitchen, like the pipes we use every day, they froze. His solution, the landlord's solution, was to turn the water off. Doesn't really work that way because we live here and we need the water. So it's things like that, like band-aid solutions. It's just not, there's a lot of things wrong with it. We don't have any closets. They were all ripped out, and so there's like a hole in each room or none at all in our bedroom. We don't have any closet whatsoever. In my office and in my daughter's room, there it looks like there's a closet, but there's no door, so it's just messy. There's no storage closet for our, like, cleaning supplies. There's no, like, downstairs, like, for a vacuum, a broom, you know, laundry, grocery bags, stuff like that. There's no upper cabinets in the kitchen. We just have big drawers, and we have a lot of cooking supplies and a lot of cooking stuff because we eat at home a lot, and we cook a lot because of being vegan, we just end up cooking a lot at home. And I like to cook too. So we just have a lot of food supplies all the time, and we don't really have a place to store them. So our kitchen always looks messy. Things are always out. There's a lot of leaking faucets. There's a lot of water damage in the basement that comes under the rug. So the rug gets wet, and it smells like cat pee. It's gross. It's not a good smell, and it's not from our cats. It's from maybe people that lived here before. Not cool. There's quite a few things wrong with it that just aren't being fixed that we're sick of having to deal with. Our landlord doesn't live close by, so it's like we're stuck with things a lot. That's just the tip of the iceberg. And yes, first world problems. We're lucky to have a really nice big house. Anyway, long story short, we decided to move. And I'm not even going to talk about it right now, what we did, what we decided, but it's exciting. Once it's firmed up a little bit more, I will talk about it more, and I'm actually going to be starting a vlog, I think, on another YouTube channel, but that's another adventure. It's an adventure, let's just say that. So we are moving. Right now, my office is a mess. I'm in the process of getting rid of a ton of stuff. We're downsizing, basically, and you'll see what we're doing. It's fun. It's interesting. It's a little scary, but it's an adventure in life again. And so that's my big news for now. I think I covered everything, and the ways to reach me on Ravelry is Miko Biko, and then there's a Ravelry group for the podcast, the Knitspire podcast, and on Instagram you can find me as Kamiko MC Knitspired with underscores in between each, but it'll be on screen or down below. You'll be able to get in touch with me easily. I love to hear from people. Send me a message, say hi, whatever. A couple of, I'm like out of, like all out of order, but I did want to say that there's another podcast that I checked out. I think it's called Charlotte and Gus, and I only watched like two or three episodes, so I don't even know if she's still making them, but she's super, super adorable, and she's in France, and she speaks English well, like better than English-speaking people speak it. So she's cute. Check her out. I'm not sure if she's still recording, but what she does have so far was really good, and she's a really good knitter. And the other podcast that I was thinking of completely escaped my mind, but there's a few I do want to check out that I haven't yet. I've just been catching up on other podcasts and just kind of busy lately with doing stuff, doing other stuff. I think that is it for now, and hopefully I will get another podcast recorded soon. My hair, I could see like flyaways and like broken hair halo. Sorry if I'm fiddly with my hair today. Yeah, so I think that's it. So thank you so much for watching, and I hope to hear from you or whatever, and yeah, thanks for spending time with me. Okay, bye. Bye. Henry wants to say bye. He looks super lazy right now. He looks pissed, but he's not. He's super happy. He's so heavy. Okay, for real. Bye.